guys, this is Spider Rock, and welcome to the top 10 add-ons of 2020. This is the video that I will annually do where I talk about the 10 best add-ons that I have either showcased or used on videos or streams during this year. I guess we should probably get right into the count, but if you want to see all my add-on showcases, there will be a link in the description to that playlist, as well as links to videos that you can find on each of these add-ons, or just the link to the MCPDL post. I'm also going to give some honorable mentions before I reach the number one spot. I guess let's hop right into this. All right, at the number 10 spot for the best add-on of the year is the Into the Maelstrom add-on by Dr. Game. This was released fairly recently. It is by Dr. Game. He is a great add-on creator, and it was based off of the Java Edition mod. It's a really good add-on, and it adds a lot of stuff into the game, a whole like story-based thing after you play in the world for a little while, but it is not fully updated yet. This would be probably in the top spot if it was completely updated, but it is still being worked on, still being updated. That's why it's at the sort of number 10 place where it is, but it's a really cool add-on and I really recommend checking it out. At the number 9 spot is the Lucky Blocks add-on by Effect99MC. This is a really, really high quality Lucky Block add-on that adds in good Lucky Blocks, bad Lucky Blocks, structure Lucky Blocks, as well as just regular Lucky Blocks that spawn in all kinds of different things, mobs, structures, items, loot, more Lucky Blocks even, and it feels the closest that I've seen to the Java Edition mod, or at least like one of the original Java Edition mods, and it's a really high quality Lucky Block add-on, so if you're at all interested in Lucky Blocks or anything like that, it's definitely worth checking out. At the number 8 spot for the best add-on of 2020 is the Bioplunia add-on by Mark Jones. This is an add-on that adds in some really good biomes and some new revamped biomes, and it just makes our world a lot more vibrant and interesting, and there's all kinds of new, you know, interesting, I guess, trees and stuff to explore. It's a really nice looking biome add-on, and if you really want to make your world just look that much better and cooler, it's a really good one to choose. Alright, at the number 7 spot is the World Edit add-on by HR3 Edits. I've seen a ton of World Edit add-ons this year, but this is probably the best one I've seen simply because it adds in its own whole UI where you can select things and you can change things, you can clone things, and it just generally works really well. It's only ever messed up for me once, which is actually pretty surprising because the other World Edit add-ons that I have tried have all bugged out like half of the time I've tried to use them. This one is pretty consistent and works almost all the time, and I'd really recommend it for a scenario where you'd want to, you know, edit your world like regular world edit. At the number 6 spot for best add-on of the year is the Quarry add-on, also by Effect99MC. This is the highest quality Quarry add-on that I've seen so far, and I've seen some more ones rise up after this one came out, and, you know, well, I guess after this one started to gain a little bit more popularity. It's a really high quality add-on. Everything is really simple. It's no more complicated or crazy than it should be. And I would really recommend it to anybody looking for that genuine, just solid quarry experience that doesn't want anything that goes overboard and doesn't want anything insane, but just wants something good and high quality and well done and usable in survival. All right, at the number 5 spot is the Hidwoods add-on by Tumaxed44. So the Hidwoods add-on is essentially its own game. It revamps the entire world of Minecraft into this whole, like, they've got new biomes, new structures. They've even got like loot crates for cosmetics that you don't have to pay for with real life money, because that would be stupid. There's NPCs and all kinds of stuff, all kinds of new mobs, and it's a really, really fun add-on. It's its own whole thing. So if you're gonna play it, you're gonna play it entirely as is. You're not gonna add more things to it. I mean, you can. I'd also like to say that I'm not including add-on packs in this list, because they would probably be at the top, things like the Vatinage add-on pack and Expansion Plus. Just to keep things fair, we're looking at like standalone add-ons. All right, at the number 4 spot is the More Structures add-on by iCorbin. This is a really, really detailed add-on that adds in all kinds of new structures for you to explore. It adds in new trees, it adds in new plants and rocks, and not just that, also new houses, all kinds of stuff, little dungeon things like towers that you can explore. There's so much to do in this add-on, so much to see, and it's being updated fairly regularly, or at least last I checked it was being updated. All right, at the number three spot, a personal favorite of mine, I mean, I guess these are all personal favorites, the Damage Indicators add-on by Copdane. This is a really good damage indicator add-on. There's a ton out there. This is probably the best one. It will not only show you how much damage you're doing to something when you hit it, it'll show how much health that thing has in like its own little UI that like hovers above things' heads. It's really cool. You can change the font. You can have it be bars instead of numbers. It's generally really useful. And if you're going to have a world with add-ons on it, you'd probably want to have that add-on on because it's really good. At the number two spot is the Advanced Machinery add-on by Vatnage/IEmotionless. This is an insanely well done add-on that adds in all kinds of new machinery and technology for your world. It's all powered by RFs, redstone frequencies that you can, I think it's redstone frequencies, I'm not sure. Anyway, you can use it to power these machines that can generate things for you. They can do tasks for you. I think they've recently added like a new hopper kind of thing, like an automatic pulling hopper. It's really, really cool, and it's really worth checking out. Before we go to number one, I'm going to talk about a couple honorable mentions. So I'd like to mention the custom Lucky Blocks add-on by Dr. Game. I don't know if it still works anymore. I also don't know if anybody other than me would really care about it that much. I've always thought it was so cool because I checked it out before I knew how to make add-ons. I just thought it was so cool that you could make your own Lucky Blocks. It's a pretty neat add-on, and I will also leave a link in the description. My other honorable mention is the Actual Gun CSO V2.9, I guess that's what it's on right now, add-on. It has been updated a ton. It adds in some nice, like, high-quality, you know, 2D weapons. You can ADS with some of them. It's a really, really good add-on. But because of what I have in the number one spot, that's why this is an honorable mention. I don't want to have two of a very similar thing on this list. I want to give it some diversity. And now that brings us to our number one spot. Drumroll, please. Actually, I'm not going to add in a drumroll because I'm lazy. Anyway, the number one spot for best add-on of the year is the Actual Guns 3D add-on by Pixel Poly. This is an insanely well-made add-on that adds in tons, well, not tons, but a solid amount of new weapons for your Minecraft game that are in full 3D. Yes, you can hold them in 3D. You can aim down their sights in 3D. It's insanely cool. I don't know how they did it. I mean, I'm assuming that it has something to do with how tridents work, but it's really good. They have a Discord and they're always posting what they're working on there. It's getting very regular updates and they've got a bunch of people working on it. They've got people working on the animations and the models and people working on the programming, and it's really good. I'm even working on a map right now for this add-on specifically. It's an extremely high quality and very good add-on, and I definitely recommend checking it out. So that is why it's taking the add-on of the year, even though it's not even usable in survival. I just think because of the technology that it's using is sort of, I guess, was revolutionary, I'm gonna say, for the add-on community, and that now a bunch of people are using similar technologies to make their add-ons work and look really good. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you made it to here, that was my list of top 10 add-ons for the year. Let me know what your top 10 add-ons are down in the comment section, and you can find links to pages or videos about all of these add-ons in the description if you are interested. Stay tuned for next year, more add-on showcases to come. It's been a pretty good year for add-ons, I'd say, although not for most of the world. But we don't have to get into that. You guys already know all the stuff that's going on. Thanks for watching. If you made it to here, see you guys later, and bye.